The body count for those associated with the Clintons or with Clinton dealings has now topped 90. A long list going all the way back to August of 1987 has revealed that a few websites with names, dates, and circumstances, more than half of them being suicides, many suspicious murders and, unbelievably, plane and helicopter crashes. There have been tales of these Clinton body bags going around for a couple of decades, but the stories have been quashed by the fake news industrial complex as urban legends that cannot be verified. If there are so many on this list, however, the verification should be rather easy to perform, especially when names, dates and circumstances are included. A quick trip to NY Times archives should help, whose headlines go back all the way into the 1800s. Back in the 1990s, after a disgraced Bill Clinton lost his legacy hopes to the stain on the blue dress, he immediately went to the Bushes on his knees asking them to revive him from the dead and rebuild his legacy. One of those rebuilding missions was the Haiti recovery effort, where it was later revealed that massive fraud in the recovery led to very lucrative payments to the Clinton Foundation. A doctor who had participated in those recovery efforts, Dean Lorick, who was very vocal in his criticism of the Clintons, was found dead in his NYC apartment on Sunday of an apparent suicide, by a knife to the chest, the Political Insider. Dr. Dean Lorick, an acclaimed trauma surgeon who famously criticized Bill and Hillary Clinton's relief efforts in Haiti, was found dead in his New York City apartment on Sunday. Lorick's 11-year-old daughter found him dead in the bathroom with a knife in his chest. Cops say there were no signs of forced entry into the apartment, and Lorick's wife was playing tennis at the time. They're treating his death as an apparent suicide, but who commits suicide by stabbing themselves in the chest? Adding to the intrigue surrounding Lorick's death is the fact that he openly criticized the relief effort in Haiti following the devastating 2010 earthquake. That relief effort was, of course, largely spearheaded by Bill and Hillary Clinton, who was serving as Secretary of State at the time. Lorick witnessed the situation in Haiti firsthand. After traveling to the island, he wrote an email to a confidant describing the disaster. "Disaster management on the ground was non-existent," Lorick wrote. "The difficulties in getting in, despite the intelligence we had from people on the ground and David Helfand's high political connections with partners in health as well as the Clintons, only portended the difficulties we would have once we arrived." That email somehow ended up in the inbox of Hillary advisor Cheryl Mills, who forwarded it to Hillary. Much like Seth Rich's murder, based on the details we have thus far, Lorick's death just doesn't add up. The New York Post reports that Lorick had been stripped of his privileges to practice at New York Presbyterian Hospital just days before his apparent suicide, so that could have played a factor. But again, a self-inflicted stab wound to the chest is in a wee strange way to commit to suicide, and one that seems like it would be very painful and slow. As a doctor, wouldn't Lorick want it to be as quick and painless as possible? Whatever the case, this is certainly a tragedy for Lorick's family and the medical community. When the suicide is someone unskilled in medical technology and it happens to be a knife to the chest, there is less questioning. However, as stated above, the fact that a skilled trauma surgeon opted to kill himself with a method so brutal and painful, not to mention that his 11-year-old daughter was present in the home to find him, stretches credulity. Whether or not this doctor had been asked to leave a hospital staff, he would still theoretically have ready access to medications as well. Why stab himself in the chest? I'm not a conspiracy theorist by any stretch of the imagination, but to call this an urban legend, which is exactly what the FNIC will call this in a year or two, is a disservice to the family of this doctor. Source: The Political Insider. Clinton Foundation, Dean Lorick, exposed, fraud, Hillary Clinton.